you are a Japanese learner and recognize this kanji but not this kanji, you have the Chinese font issue.
What the f*** is this piece of sh-?
This issue affects all users using Windows computers that aren't using the Japanese UI. If you aren't sure whether you're having this issue or not, open up Anki and press Create a New Card. Then, from the description of this video, copy this kanji, whichever one it looks like, and paste it like so. Then, press the card button up here to preview what it looks like. And you want to check what it looks like on both sides of the card, so click here to check the back side as well. And if it does not look like this, you have the Chinese font issue. First, I will explain what's causing this issue, then I will explain how to solve it for Anki and Chrome. If you would like to skip to the fix, please jump to this timestamp. Right, so why is this happening? As some of you are aware, some kanji can look different in Chinese and Japanese despite being the same thing. Matter of fact, there are two types of Chinese, simplified and traditional, and all three can have slightly different looking kanjis for the same character. This is not something that can be changed with fonts, because all these are separate characters. What this means is that I can copy them from the description into Anki and they will all remain different. The reason they are still different is because all these three kanjis have different unicodes. Unicodes are what computers use to recognize what a character is supposed to be. So, for example, if the English small letter A has the unicode 61, then whenever I type A, the computer recognizes that I've inputted unicode 61 and displays whatever unicode 61 is supposed to look like in the font that I'm using. And using the Arial font, it looks like this. Now, if I wanted to change it so it looks like this, I could change the font into something that has it, like Comic Sans. As you can see, this and this, despite looking different, shares the same unicode and is the same thing. However, if I wanted to change the small a into a capital A, instead of changing fonts, I simply press down the shift key. This enters an entirely different unicode, unicode 41, which is the capital A. So the small a and big A, despite both being A, does not share the same unicode and are different. So, going back to these kanji, these three kanji have separate unicode, like the small a and capital A. These two kanji have the same unicode, like the two small a's. By default, Windows assigns all kanji to use the Chinese font, meaning that kanjis like these will all get defaulted to the Chinese counterpart instead of Japanese. To fix this, there are multiple solutions. Solution 1 is to switch your entire computer's operating system into Japanese, which is something you should be doing anyway to immerse yourself more with the language. But you'll also need to learn how to use your computer in Japanese if you do this. Don't worry though, because if you need to switch back into English, you can do that at any time as well. So to do this, press the Windows key and search for Language, and you're looking for Language Settings. This window will pop up, and right here, this is the Windows Display Language. Set this to Japanese. If Japanese is not here, then on the bottom right here, you want to add Japanese first. Once you set your computer to Japanese, everything should be displaying the correct way. If it's still not displaying properly, restart your computer, and if that still doesn't work, I will be explaining how to diagnose the problems with Chrome and Anki after I talk about solution 2. Okay, and solution 2 does not involve changing your computer into Japanese. For this, we simply press Windows I and search for optional. We're looking for add an optional feature. Then we want to press this add button here, and you're looking for Japanese supplemental fonts. Again, once you've done this, everything should be displaying properly. If it doesn't, restart your computer. And if that still doesn't work, let's diagnose Anki and Chrome individually. For Anki, once you've done either of the above steps, if the kanji is still not displaying properly, we need to tell Anki what font to use. Go to Anki and open up your browser. Click on a card you want to edit, and keep in mind this affects the template, so any card that uses this template will be affected. click on card over here. This will open the card type editor. And in the card type, we want to have a line that looks like this. Check that you don't already have something like this in your card formatting. If you do have something similar, just update the font family to any of these default fonts that you're seeing on screen right now. Whichever one you want to use, just write that in after font family. And make sure you remember to do this for both sides of the card as well. Next, if the issue is still persisting on Chrome, open up Chrome and click these three dots on the top right here and go to Settings. On the left, go to Appearance or Design. Here you can find Customize Fonts, and you want to set the fonts to what I have here. That should solve it, but also you can go into Language on the left side here, and on the top, this is Language Priority. You can add Japanese if it's not here already, and press the three dots here and check the box to tell Chrome to use this as your default language. For more tips on learning Japanese, watch this video next.